this that you would know.
Martha said the blight had spread even further south, pushing yet more monsters down with it. I dare say. We'll be seeing a few along the way.
Then we shall have to keep our wits about us.
There, boy!
Over here.
Get him, boy!
Excuse me, I'll use that blade of yours. Ugh, curse my luck, I branded. No time to haggle with whoever holds your leash. Wait, that's the slumbering chocobo you're wearing. You and the Marfers, are you? Good, she won't begrudge me the use of you then. Well, there's wolves about. We tried dealing with them ourselves. Made out bait, think we might swoop in and slaughter a lot. But we didn't expect the pack to be quite so bloody big.
I expect the Blight drove them here. They must have fled their homes for greener pastures.
We'd hoped empty bellies might make them easy prey. We'd made them mean instead. Martha's no fool, so she must see something new. Do us a favor and get rid of them, will you?
All right. I suppose those wolves pose a threat to everyone.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. I'd wager the greedy bastards are still over yonder, finishing off our bait. When you've seen to every last one of them, go and speak to my friend over the bridge. Bryce, his name is. He'll want to know if it's safe to come across. All right, off you go then.
Safe. Wonder how long that bait will last.
Bryce.
What's it to you, Bearer?
Your friend asked me to get rid of the wolves. So I got rid of the wolves.
You'd have me believe a single bearer slew the entire pack. Then again, if you didn't, you wouldn't be on this side of the bridge. Bugger me, you're a tough one, aren't you?
Oh, Frederick!
You wily bastard. I never thought to pit beast against beast like that. You served us well, Bearer. Be sure to pass our thanks to your master.
Look, the windmills. That must be Eastpool.
I remember coming here with Lord Murdoch when I was young. Rosaria seemed a very different place back then.
Get up, boy! Over here!
quiet, isn't it?
Yes.
You! You're Clive Rossfield! It's me, Hannah! Rodney Murdoch's wife!
Lady Hannah!
Oh, I knew it was you! You haven't changed at all! The Lord Marquis and Jill too. It's so good to see you both again.
It's good to see you too, Lady Hannah.
If you have time, you simply must come back to the house. I haven't much to offer, but what is mine is yours.
We should be delighted.
And you have been wandering the world ever since. I can well understand fleeing from those iron blood brutes, but oh, to take to the road at such a tender age.
Wasn't easy, but we survived, and
now we're back. It's wonderful to see you safe and well, Lady Hannah. Do you think you will stay here, in Easterpool? Rosaleth still enjoys the Mother Crystal's blessing, does it not? You could always move.
This house holds a lot of memories for me. So long as I can live here in peace, here I shall stay. Not that it matters. The capital is closed to civilians, by order of the Duchess. Or should I say, Her Imperial Majesty. Annabella's marriage to the Emperor of Sambrec heralded a great many changes here.
Yes. Of course.
Oh, forgive me. I didn't mean to... Oh.
Please. There is nothing to forgive. Would my mother not make an exception for you and your husband? Surely she would not refuse the Lord Commander.
You haven't heard, then. Rodney passed away on the night of the fire. He never returned from Phoenix Gate.
I'm sorry.
Clive.
My poor child. You look pale. All this traveling must have taken its toll. I insist you rest. We can talk later.
Are you sure you don't want to sleep inside?
I can't. Not after what I did.
Lady Hannah said she would prepare a change of clothes for you in the morning. She really has been very kind.
Thirteen years of killing. 13 years without the faintest glimmer of hope. It was only Joshua that kept me going. I swore that I would avenge his death. That I would kill his killer. That was the only thing that gave my life any meaning. But if it was me who killed Joshua and Murdoch and all the others, then why the hell am I still breathing?
I ask myself the same. When I fought, hundreds died. There were so many bodies, so many lives cut short in their prime. That day in Dalmechia, I wanted to join them. I wanted it all to end. I couldn't bear it anymore. If living meant being that, better to be just another body. Do you remember that night on the balcony, when we looked up at the moon? I said a prayer to Metia, and that prayer was answered. You came back to me. The heavens must have a plan for us. We should get some rest.
Right.
Good night, Clive. Sleep well.
Thank you, Lady Anna. Perhaps now people will not flee at the sight of me.
You look just like Elwyn did when he was your age.
How did you come to have some of my father's old clothes?
Oh, before Elwyn became Archduke, our families would often summer together. He and Rodney were like brothers. These clothes have been in a wardrobe for years, collecting cobwebs along with everything else.
Well, I'm very grateful for them. And sorry for depriving you of your memories.
Not at all. It's what your father would have wanted.
They suit you well. Thank you, Lady Hannah.
Yes, thank you. You've been most kind.
No, I should thank you. It may only have been for a short while. But seeing you again took me back to happier times. Fare you well, my lord and lady.
And you, Lady Hannah. If we follow the road to the north, it should take us all the way to Phoenix Gate. Let's go.
are you off to, then? Or hasn't your master told you?
Either way, I expect our hand.
Well met, friend. Here you go.
Those are Elwyn's. By the flames. You're his firstborn. Clive Rosfield.
You're mistaken.
Oh, you can't fool me, my lord. You're the very image of your father. And that would be true even if you weren't wearing his clothes. The selfsame garments Hannah was keeping for you, if I'm not mistaken. She always swore that she would never part with them until the day Elwyn's sons returned. And now that day has come. Why, you'll be able to take your bearers back as well.
My bearers? Forgive me, Master Mayor. I was a child when last I came to Eastpool. I didn't recognize you.
Oh, I'd be surprised if you recognized anything at all. Much has changed since Rosaria fell to the Empire. Not least for the bearers who once served her noble families. When the Iron Blood sacked Rosalith 13 years back, many who lost their masters fled here, in search of sanctuary.
And never returned.
Aye. The plan was to send them home once we'd won back the capital. But then the Imperials arrived. Rosaria became a province of Sanbrec. The duchy was dissolved, and they no longer had any home to return to. Back in your father's day, any bearer who lost their master became a ward of the duchy. We'd hand them over to the sheriffs, and they'd be assigned a new position. But when we saw how the Empire treated their branded, we knew that wasn't an option. So they've been here ever since.
And now you want to give them to me?
They're yours by right, Lord Rosfield. Bequeathed you by your late father. And they'd be better off serving you than hiding here. Indeed, many of them used to serve your house, and still consider the Rosfields their masters.
I'm no one's master. Not anymore. They wouldn't be safe with me.
I understand. You'll forgive an old man his fanciful notions. Been daydreaming for too long. But still, I would ask a favor of you. A small mercy.
If it is within my power.
One of the bearers is an elderly fellow who still swears absolute loyalty to Archduke Elwyn. I don't ask that you take him into your service, only that you meet with him. Let him see that Elwyn's son still lives, and that he's as fine a man as his father ever was.
It would be my honor.
Thank you, my lord. He sits by the well most days, watching the people go about their business. If you could show him your face, I would be most grateful.
As fine a man as my father.
You're not so very different, you know. Especially dressed like that. Come on, let's go and meet that bearer. He's not here.
Well, I can't leave without meeting him. I've let the mayor down once already. It would be cruel to disappoint him again.
Right, let's ask around. Someone must have seen him.
Good day, milady. What can I do for you?
I'm looking for a bearer, an elderly fellow who used to serve the Rosfields. Have you seen him?
Ah, that old loon. No, no sign of him today. Funny, he's usually down by the well at this hour, cooking up his fantasy feasts.
I'm sorry?
Oh, he worked in the kitchens at Rosalith Castle back in the day. Still thinks he's there now. You'd often hear the poor fool chatting away to the Archduke. Living in a dream he is. But better there than here, I suppose. Can't imagine the Viceroy stopping to trade tales with a bearer. Can you?
No.
Anyway, you'll be round here somewhere. Doubt he has the path to stray too far.
Thank you. We'll keep looking.
Well now, unfamiliar faces. What brings you to Eastpool, travelers?
We're looking for an elderly bearer. You wouldn't happen to have seen him, would you?
Ah, you mean the old boy who always waits by the well?
Yes, that's him.
What business do you have with him, if you don't mind me asking? You're not from the capital too, are you?
We are, in a way.
Well then, it's a pleasure to meet a fellow Rosalithian. I was born and raised down Market Street, and never would have left if Archduke Elwyn had survived the fire. It wasn't the same when the Duchess took over, though. All the beatings, the evictions, the levies going up and up and up, even as the blight took half the harvest. Oh, listen to me, telling you what you already know. I'm sorry. I'm afraid I can't help you with your bearer, either. Though I doubt he'll have gone far. He comes here every day, almost as if he's waiting for something.
We'll keep asking around, then. Thank you.
Hold on a mo. Patrick the Chocobo Keeper might know where your bearer is. He's taken the old boy under his wing, so to speak. You should go and have a word with him. He'll be in the stables.
Patrick the Chocobo Keeper. Thank you. We will.
I'm sorry, Jill. For making you do all this in my stead.
It can't be helped if we're to keep up the pretense. Come on, let's head for the stables.
Bloody hell's he got to?
Excuse me, but is something the matter?
It's this bearer I've been minding. I take my eyes off him for 1 minute and he disappears. He's not in his usual spot by the well, nor anywhere else in the village.
You must be Patrick.
I am, but...
And this bearer you're looking for... He's an elderly man who used to work in the Rosalith Castle kitchens, yes?
That's the fella. How do you know all this? I've never seen you in Eastpool before, but you seem to know the place better than I do myself. So that's how it is. Well then, if you're acting under orders of the mayor, you're on a bound to help me find him. He's been losing what little sense he had left of late, saying the sheriffs are coming to collect him and that he needs to go back to the castle. I was supposed to watch over him, keep him out of trouble. But if he's walked out on us, there's not a lot I can do.
Understood. Understood. You keep searching here. We'll look for him outside.
Thank you. I'm in your debt.
I hope he hasn't wandered into trouble.
Let's just concentrate on finding him.
Drink up now.
Still no sign. Could he have strayed even further? Someone over there.
It might be him. We should hurry. Company.
We can't lead them to the old man. They need to die.
Agreed.
You know what to do. Keep your distance, boy. Sit up, Torgal.
Over here.
You know what to do, boy. Get him, boy. Sick of Torgold.
Are you all right, my friend? Come on. Let's go home.
Your Grace! You came for me! I waited for you so long, but you finally came!
I'm not who you think.
Clive.
Yes. Pray forgive my long delay.
It's nothing, Your Grace. I prayed to the Founder that you would come, and at long last, he answered. Will we be returning to the castle then? There is still a place for me in the kitchens?
No, my friend. We will not be returning to the castle, not yet. I'm on a very important expedition, one which may take some time. Could you wait for me in Eastpool until my journey is complete? I will come back for you then. I promise.
Of course, Your Grace. For you, I would gladly wait until my dying day.
Thank you, both of you. You've been most kind. The memory of serving the late Archduke was his one light in the darkness, and now that light burns a little more brightly. It's nothing but a fantasy, of course, but it's better than the truth of the matter. A damn sight better. The blight is on our doorstep. Our harvests are failing. The people are leaving in droves. If it weren't for Lady Hannah selling half her worldly goods to provide for the few of us who stayed behind, we would long since have starved. We want to keep the bearers safe here, we really do. But unless a miracle happens, we won't be able to spare a crust of bread to share between them soon enough.
Is it really that bad?
So bad,
I even petitioned the Imperial garrison to take them.
But when they found out where they'd come from, they damn near spat in our faces. Ducal dogs, they called them. Enemies of the Empire.
I know a man named Cid, who would gladly give a home to any bearer in need of one. Leave this with me. As soon as I return from Phoenix Gate, I'll speak with him.
Thank you, my lord.
Will you be passing through Eastpool on your way back? I should very much like to speak with you again, if you have the time, regarding the future of the village, and what might be done for Lady Hannah, after all she's done for us.
Yes, of course. I'll be back anon.
Fare you well, my lord, my lady. I wish you a safe journey.
The Deadlands are aptly named.
I didn't realize they were this close.
No wonder their crops are failing. The blight is leaching the ether from the soil. And when the last drop is drained, their fields will turn to this. No plants, no animals, no life.
And no monsters. I suppose that's one small mercy.
What's this? Another relic of the fallen. We won't be able to use any magic here.
Another thing to worry about. As if the absence of ether didn't cause enough problems.
Take away the lad's life force, and problems are all that's left.
I can hardly imagine what this place used to look like before the Blight took it.
I remember. It was beautiful. Gate, where it all went wrong.
Come on, Clive. It's time to discover the truth. Almost as if time had stood still.
I suppose no one had any cause to return here. No. It is just as I left it. Have a look around. Could I have done this?
Could anyone? What is it, Torgal? Clive.
That's him. He's the only one who can tell me what happened. I have to know. Where is he?
Nowhere to be seen.
Damn it! He's like a bloody eel.
What is this place, anyway? Some sort of shrine?
Oh, sorry. You've never been here before. This is the Hall of the Gate.
The Gate?
It's a relic of the Fallen. Only the Phoenix's dominant can open it.
Hence the castle's name. This was where Joshua was supposed to...
Yes. He would have stepped through this door the next morning and listened to the words of our ancestors.
Would you have gone with him?
No. The Appoditary is holy ground. None but the Dominant may enter. I and the other shields would have stood guard here and prayed for my brother's safe return. Where the hell did he go?
Perhaps he went inside.
He couldn't have. He'd need the power of the Phoenix.
Are you sure about this?
Nevermore. Another gate. Let's see if this one opens.
Call it a ruin. It's perfect. Like it was built yesterday.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
Jill. Trouble.
Sick of Torgal. It's over.
How can these things still function?
How can any of this? This must be what the fallen ruins were like before they fell.
Take a beating.
Then let's give it one.
Get him, boy! Give them all you've got, boy. Get him, boy! You know what to do, boy. Get him! There, boy. You know what to do. Get him. Not this time. Over here. Get him.
This makes sense to you?
None. Let's find the hooded man and leave.
Joshua have had to run this gauntlet too?
No. At least not that I ever heard about. I imagine the Phoenix would receive a warmer welcome.
Here we go again. Where will we end up this time?
Surrounded by contraptions hell-bent on murdering us, I expect. Could the Hooded Man really have taken this path?
We won't know until we've followed it all the way to the end. Come on, let's keep looking.
Sick of Toggle! Get up, boy! There, boy!
Too slow.
One more!
Don't let them get away.
Keep your distance, boy. There, boy! Get up, boy! You know what to do, boy.
like this.
Feelings mutual.
You know what to do, boy. Sick of Togo.
It's done.
What are these creatures? And why do they keep attacking us?
They're probably asking themselves the same thing. We're the ones trespassing here. They're just protecting their home. Jill, look.
Is that some kind of mural?
It's worth a closer look, whatever it is.
seem this place holds even more secrets than we thought.